Matukaru Wingara, Narinan Yari Penny, Natawilipani Yang Nanurpa, Kaka Baninga, Baron, Mratanula Bungadich.
Baron is Mount Gambier, scene of the last volcanic eruption on the Australian mainland. Auntie Penny tells the dreaming story of Crate Bull, who travelled this landscape building giant ovens to feed his family.
Crate Bull built another oven, and this oven is called Perrine, Mount Shane.
But everywhere he went, there were warnings from the Bullen Bird.
And Crapel thought, oh, war, the evil spirits here.
So finally, he moved to Baron, Mount Gambier.
They were cooking their food, and then all of a sudden, something strange happened, the water come up and put the fire out.
The Aboriginal people across Australia have been witness to at least 13 or 14 eruptions in the last 50 to 65,000 years.
For 4.5 million years, this area has had active volcanoes, hundreds of them. And the science tells us that one day, they're going to wake up.
And the last eruption was only 5,000 years ago. Why would it stop? So I think we can expect to see another eruption in future. The question is when.
Should I be worried?
So that huge area between Melbourne and Mount Gambier, the region is still considered to have potential for a future eruption somewhere in the area.
In fact, 400 volcanoes have been identified in the area known as the Newer Volcanics Province.
We just don't know where a volcano might pop up, and it could be in somebody's backyard.
Let's go back over 5,000 years.
This huge block of rock we can see is all lava from one of the early lava flows around the Mount Gambier complex. This lava, when it was erupted, was probably 1,100 degrees.
Over time, the type of eruptions here changed. The slow-moving Hawaiian-style lava flows became something far more dramatic when molten rock met with groundwater.
And what happens when you mix hot magma with cold water is that it creates an explosive reaction. And so that's what blasts the rock, the surrounding rock above in the surface away, and creates this huge kind of hole that often fills with water afterwards.
Which is exactly what happened at Mount Gambier's famous Blue Lake.
So these ones are fragments of the Earth's mantle. So these come from deep below our feet.
How deep?
So at least 35, 40 kilometers below our feet. And they've been carried to the surface by the magma. The fact that you've got these big chunks of the Earth's mantle coming to the surface, you might have in the order of hours to days notice for it to move all the way from the mantle to the surface.
Oh my God, that's not very long.
What the science shows is Mount Gambier's last eruption was the same size as Iceland's in 2010, the one which grounded tens of thousands of flights across Europe.
If you superimpose that ash cloud from Eyjafjallajökull on Mount Gambier, you know, as an example of a size 4 eruption, and then put the prevailing wind condition, it could reach as far as Auckland.
So what warning systems are in place? 25 kilometres from Mount Gambier, beneath these towers, is Geoscience Australia's closest seismometer. Their focus is not on volcanoes, but on tremors measuring magnitude of 3 and above.
There might be a lot of them, but they could be quite small compared to what's being detected at present by Geoscience Australia.
And most monitors are spaced hundreds of kilometres apart.
What we'd really want if we were trying to look for signs of pre-eruptive activity before an eruption, we'd want more seismometers over a smaller area.
Not that seismometers offer any protection, but they could give locals at least a few hours' warning of an eruption. Meantime, you have to admire the pragmatism of Mount Gambier's mayor.
I think we've just come to accept we do live on the side of a volcano, and perhaps I could say, you know, we're bold and we love living life on the edge.
For the moment, all is serene. There are no warnings from the seismologists or the Bullen Bird. And the stunning landscape masks any hidden menace.
You look around at this beautiful landscape, what do you see?
It's absolutely beautiful. It's mysterious. Mysterious.
I cannot get over how stunning that looks.
Yes, beautiful.
And 400 volcanoes? I would have guessed none.
I would have guessed 380.
Well, that's a good guess.
I know a lot about volcanoes.
Do you know what? I bet there's an app somewhere you can put a bet on that.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Mm. Okay. We'll get your responsibility.